Hello, I'm SeungA Chung from Ewha Womans University. Understanding 3D position of surrounding objects is important for users to decide whether to interact with or to avoid those objects. However, locating objects visually can be inefficient and frustrating in 3D space. Moreover, this approach may not be feasible in some situations where the visual information is difficult to deliver. For these reasons, many researchers investigated design implication of directional guidance with non-visual feedback. However, most of the studies were limited to two-dimensional space, so we conducted a prior study focused on how to convey omnidirectional information in 3D space. In the prior study, we found that users have a tendency of scanning the 3D environment in a horizontal direction first and then in a vertical direction for finding a target, regardless of non-visual feedback conditions such as audio or haptic. Inspired by this finding, we proposed a two-step omnidirectional guidance so that horizontal or vertical direction is provided one at a time based on the shortest Cartesian distance instead of guiding users based on the Euclidean distance, which is shorter. We conducted a user study with a target finding task to investigate three different feedback conditions for conveying omnidirectional guidance to users. We designed three different feedback conditions for the user study. First one is the vertical first condition, and we will call this VF condition from now on. It provides directional guidance to users in two steps, first vertical direction and then horizontal direction. It plays a beeping sound repeatedly to guide users towards the target height. We set the blue region, which looks like a disk, as shown in the figure, to indicate the vertical position of the target. The height of the disk is set to a diameter of the target. When the region is reached, the same beeping sound is played again to guide the user to the exact 3D position of the target. Second one is the horizontal first condition, and we will call this HF condition from now on. It provides the guidance similar to the VF condition, but in the reversed order. A horizontal direction is provided first, and the vertical direction is followed. Other mechanisms are same with VF condition, except the blue region, which looks like a piece of pie that indicates the horizontal position of the target. The angle of the region is set to 10 degrees in XZ plane, which is close to the angle of two tangent lines of the target spear from the position of the user. The beeping sound is played repeatedly to guide the users to the blue region, in this case the target direction, or the exact 3D position of the target. We also designed a one-step directional guidance called NO condition to compare with the first two conditions. In this condition, there is no certain order when finding the target objects. The beeping interval decreases as the laser ray cast gets closer to the exact 3D position of the target object. We set the blue region to indicate the target position in various directions so that users can recognize that the laser ray cast is near the target. For the experiments, we built a virtual reality environment using Unity running on the desktop computer, a handheld controller of HTC Vive Pro I and external speaker were used to convey the output feedback. As for the target finding task, 10 spear targets were used and all of them had the same distance between the position of the participants and itself. We played a beeping sound for audio feedback, where its interval decreased as the pointer got closer to the target region or the exact target position. Also, we turned on the vibration motor for haptic feedback when the pointer was in the blue region to inform users that they found the target's vertical or horizontal position or the target was nearby. When the laser pointer entered the exact target position, participants received short vibration feedback where the intensity was doubled compared to the region vibration, along with a chime sound for confirmation. We conducted a user study with 12 blindfolded participants. They were asked to point 10 virtual targets using a handheld controller under the three conditions. After that, we asked them the subjective feedback of the conditions, including preference and ratings. As a result, the average time was shortest in HF condition, followed by VF, then NO condition. Although the time difference between VF and HF is not found to be statistically significant, two-step guidance conditions were more efficient than one-step guidance condition. Similar to this, the average distance was shortest in HF condition, followed by VF, then NO condition. To be more specific, it is found that the travel distance under HF condition was significantly shorter than other two conditions. We also analyzed the duration of each step of two-step guidance to find the effect of searching direction. We found that participants were faster under HF condition than VF condition in horizontal search. On the other hand, they were faster under VF condition than HF condition in vertical search. These results were also shown on the travel distance. When we analyze participants' traces, it is found that participants tend to make less sudden changes in directions in the two-step conditions than one-step condition. Although participants were confused about which direction to move once they receive guidance for vertical or horizontal direction, the number of sudden directional changes was more prevalent when finding the exact target location in NO condition. In addition, the tendency of finding the target direction first before finding the exact position in 3D was confirmed under NO condition. Finally, we analyzed ratings of each condition evaluated in a 5-point Likert scale. Most participants perceived that all three feedback conditions are easy to understand, particularly for HF condition. Similarly, HF condition received the best ratings in terms of fatigue and satisfaction. Reflecting the results of subjective evaluation, HF conditions received the highest number of votes when asked for preference. The main reason was that finding horizontal direction first is less exhausting since they do not have to stay their arm in specific heights. On the other hand, 5 participants preferred VF condition more because they felt they moved their arm less so that the condition was comfortable. The findings show that our two-step guidance is faster with shorter travel distance than one-step guidance, although it was designed based on the shortest Cartesian distance, which is longer than based off one-step guidance Euclidean distance. Also, we observed the tendency of dividing the task into two steps even under the one-step guidance. This could be due to the low cognitive load, since the participants could focus on one direction at a time with two-step guidance. Also, we found that HF condition showed better performance than VF condition in terms of travel distance and subjective evaluation, especially on fatigue and satisfaction. This could be due to the gorilla arm problem, as finding the horizontal direction of the target while lifting one's arm at the target height in VF condition is physically more difficult compared to the HF condition. Thus, we recommend giving two-step guidance in horizontal direction first for informing the target's 3D position. Our findings show that the participants were faster in the first step than the second step in two-step conditions. Extra cognitive load during the second step can be occurred as participants had to focus on performing two subtasks with multiple output modalities. It can be also explained by ballistic and correction phases of goal-directed 3D movements, where rough movements were made in the first step and fine adjustments were made in the last step. Although we confirmed the effect of non-visual guidance, we observed the sudden changes in direction from the trace analysis occurred by the confusion of deciding direction in the first move. While we used proximity-based feedback through different modalities to reduce the distraction from conveying different types of information through the same channel, further investigation about the effect of specialized sound on the performance of two-step guidance is needed. Although we tried to map the vibrating region based on the size and the distance of the target, we believe that the region can be optimized. If the region is set to big, the region itself can be found easily, but the search space within the region is still too wide to find the accurate target position. For example, we noticed that our blue region of NO condition was set too wide, that the traces for NO condition have zigzag motion near the target. On the other hand, if the range of the region is too small, users would not benefit from the additional cue since finding the region can be difficult as much as finding the target. We used audio feedback mainly to convey the information. However, there are some difficulties to rely on audio feedback in noisy environments. Also, listening to the surrounding environment sound is important for safety. Thus, bone-conductive headset or another modality feedback such as haptic should be reconsidered. Also, there are some limitations to apply the system in the real world, as we assume that the target position is known and that user's pointing direction is detected. Thus, technologies should be improved for tracking one's pointing finger or recognizing a target's 3D position, including depth, in a real environment. As for the implementation of such a system, a wearable camera that can generate 360-degree panoramic images should be considered to detect surrounding objects. We propose two-step omnidirectional non-visual guidance for finding a target in 3D spaces and found its effectiveness compared to one-step guidance by conducting a user study. The findings show that our two-step guidance outperforms the default condition, especially when the horizontal direction guidance is provided first. Based on the findings, we plan to extend our work by applying and evaluating the design, focusing on conveying the frequent changes in object's direction with respect to user's location in both virtual and real-world environments.